Question number 2.20. A horizontal cylinder closed from one end is rotated with a constant angular velocity about a vertical axis passing through the open end of cylinder. Means there is a vertical axis, it is passing through open end of cylinder, another end is closed and it is rotating about this axis. Okay. The outside air pressure is equals to P naught. The temperature is T naught. Outside pressure is P naught and temperature is T. And the molar mass of air is equals to M. M is the molar mass. Okay. Find the air pressure as a function of distance R from the rotation axis. Means at any distance we have to find out a function of R, okay, that is pressure in terms of R. Okay. The molar mass is assumed to be independent of R. Okay. So here we are assuming that the molar mass of gas is not changing with the position. Okay. So let's see, when this particular cylinder will rotate about the axis, then due to rotation there must be some centrifugal force. Okay. So let's take a small element at distance r having width dr over. Right. Now it will assume the pressure at this end as P. So definitely there would be some change when we move away from this terminal. So this is P plus dP. Okay, so what would be the force working on this segment? If we assume that the cross-sectional area of the cylinder is S, then force is equals to pressure into area, right? Or P into S, as we assumed in this case, P into S. Okay, so how much force working on this segment? That is P plus dP into S minus the force at this face, that is P into S. And it must be equals to centrifugal force working on it due to rotation of this. Okay, so let's assume mass of this portion is dm. So force would be dm into r into omega square, right? So from here we can just simplify this. So ps would be cancelled out. This is dp into s, and dm can be written as rho, density, area is s, okay, and the width of this segment is dr, so it is volume, rho into volume into r into omega square. Okay, so this S would get cancelled out. So from here we'll get dP is equals to rho r omega square into dr. Okay, this is our first equation. Right. Now from here we can use, if we consider 1 mole of gas. Okay, so we can use PV is equals to RT, gas equation. Right. So from here, the volume would be RT over P. Now it is given that the molar mass is M. So if we'll divide molar mass by the volume, then we'll get the density, that is M over V. Okay. So from here, we'll get density is MP over R into P. Okay. So now we can substitute this value of density in equation number 1. So we can get from equation number 1, that is dP is equals to MP over RT in place of rho into R omega square and dr. Okay. So here we can see this is a variable, so we can just arrange the variables accordingly. And let's take out the constant terms out of the integration. So this is m omega square rt into r into dr. Okay. Now we have to check the pressure how as a function of r, right? So it will take the integration. So it, in question it is given that the pressure at open end is p naught. So we should start from p naught. As we move away from this axis, then let's take pressure is P. At initially this distance was 0 and this distance is R. So if we'll integrate this, so from there we'll get, this is natural log ln P, and limit is going from P naught to P for this, and for this portion it is m omega square RT into R, because limit is going from 0 to R. So this term will be reduced as ln P over P naught, right? And this is equals to m omega square over RT into R. So we can remove this ln term. So P over P naught is equals to exponential m omega square over RT into R, right? So from here we can get the proper expression for pressure, okay? That is P equals to P naught into e to power m omega square over R into T. So this is our final expression, that how pressure is changing with distance R from the axis of rotation.